Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Evan Better Presents. Today we start part two of our Prison Architect Let's Play. So let's get right back into it where we left off. Okay, so where we left off, we were just getting our power installed. And the workmen have just finished building the other cell there, the holding cell area. So we're just going to get the water hooked up, get the main power lines run over into the cell block. Because we do have 8 more prisoners showing up in 17 minutes, so we got to get this stuff done here. Again, this video is probably good. You can probably be able to hear me talking, a different audio track in the background. Sorry about that. There's only about 3 videos where that's going to happen, and then the rest of the videos don't have that issue. Still, it's a little annoying. Sorry about that. Anyway, let's see what we got going on here. Okay, so let's try and get some of these office doors installed here. Get some of these offices up and running. Get a warden. You know, get some maintenance guys. Look at this idiot. What did you do? You trapped yourself in that room. And, oh, and you just happen to have a door to be able to get yourself out. But you couldn't install it. No, no, no. You'd rather live in a locked room forever. Frickin' idiot. Look at this guy. What a joker. A frickin' joker. Also, I would have figured that when they were installing the foundations, they would have got rid of that tree. But, okay, so there's a tree in our foundation. Must be European contractors. Anyway, let's see. Okay, so we've got some basic cells lined up here. Let's see if we can't get these guys to finish off some of the work here. We'll install the prison doors or the jail cell doors. Get everything rolling. Try and get some of these utilities in quickly. Now we're gonna keep all the doors at the same spot, just for some simplicity's sake. And let's see. Okay, they've got the power cable mostly installed. That's good to see. And let's see what we're gonna do with this here, because the shower's gonna be in the center, and then the cells will be on the outside there. Okay. What else we gotta get done? Okay, so these guys, we're going to leave that power cable right there, you know, that way it goes through the kitchen, or sorry, through the canteen and the kitchen, we can get that sorted out easily. We're going to need to make sure that the kitchen's a little bit bigger than it probably needs to be, but we're going to make sure there's ample power for it. And we'll do this line over here for the offices. And we're just going to run a power line down this hallway here so that all the lights have a connection. Hopefully they can get some of this connected soon enough. We don't need that trace. Don't need that trace. All right, so that's going to be the holding cell, which we desperately need at the moment. So let's just try and figure out how many beds we're gonna put in, how many showers, or how many toilets and such. I figure probably 6. 6 would be good for now. I know it's not even 8, which is generally what we're receiving, but hopefully we've got enough, we'll have enough cells put up. As soon as we get some more money, I think we're gonna be running out pretty soon. So 3. Let's go for 6. 4, 5, and 6. Okay, 2 benches. 1, 2. And I guess perhaps we'll put a wall up right here. Just give them enough space for that. And we'll connect this wall right here. Okay. And I guess 3 toilets would probably be enough for these guys. There's going to be 6 guys in there, maybe 8 guys at any one time. 3 toilets should be good enough. So 1, 2, 3. And let's do a check to make sure that these guys are getting everything else done. Let's dismantle this door. Doesn't need to be there anymore. Okay, he's got that installed. All right, let's see if we can't get some of these offices up and running here. So office, office. Okay. One. Oh. That's gonna come back, and I'm gonna catch that in a few minutes. The fact that these offices are too small. Size minimum requirement is 4x4. Oh well. Okay, so I still haven't figured that one out at this point, but it's gonna come back and bite me in the ass real soon. Put the desk right there. Chair and our filing cabinet. So, you know, the basic layout is you know what you guys are seeing there. So we're gonna have the administrative offices. I kind of screwed this area up a little bit. Wasn't really planning for a 4x4 office when I was building this. Big mistake on my part. Not a big deal though. It'll be easy enough to fix. And at the end of the day, who really cares about the administrative offices? Because I mean, it's not really required for them to have access to the rest of the prison or anything like that. They don't do anything. They just stay in their offices the whole time, so it really doesn't matter. Maybe in the future the warden will walk around or something like that, but for right now it doesn't really matter. So let's just run our utilities here. Let's see if we can't get some of these toilets up and going here so the guys can at least go to the washroom, because I mean, we've got 11 minutes before another group of guys show up to our prison, and we are not ready for the first 8 that we have. So we'll let those guys get that all installed there. It's always best to get a lot of your utilities built early on, because once the walls and shit start going up, these idiots have to walk through doors, they've gotta wait for guards to open up cells, and all the other bullshit, which is not fun. So we'll just build this wall. Okay, so those guys are going to walk around. Probably should have given them a door out to the outside here, just so it makes things easier for them to walk in. So this guy's going to build up that wall there. So, you know, I'm thinking down the road, maybe we can get a few more things set up in our prison. Try and yeah, we'll see how the population responds. I'd like to, like I said, I'd like to switch it over to all high-risk bastards at some point. I mean, there's a lot more money coming in from those guys, but they're also a lot more feisty, and they cause a lot of shit. But we'll see how things go. For the meantime, we'll just cram these guys in the holding cell. Since they've been standing in the deliveries area. You know what? It was probably better to leave them in the deliveries area, because when they're in the deliveries area, they don't have any needs or wants, as far as I can tell. Well, I mean, they do, but they don't act up. I've never seen them riot while they're waiting to be put in cells. So, like, this guy's already asking for food or a toilet or something like that. So, right off the bat, we've already got an issue with these guys who are in the holding cell. They've all got needs and wants that I'm not meeting, because I don't even have a canteen built, let alone a kitchen or cells or anything like that. It's all still to be made. So that's going to come back to bite me in the ass, I'm pretty sure. But in the meantime, let's at least get these guys to bed so that we can get some of their needs met. That way, when we do throw them into the prison, into their own cells, they aren't going to be rioting right away, because they are desperate for this, that, and the other thing, and we don't have our regime set up. So we've got our initial cell block built here, or at least half of it. Let's get some of these beds in. Let's plan it for, I think the bed would be best put right here, and then the toilet at the base of the bed. That way they still got a little bit of space. And we'll make it so that in the future we can mirror with the cloning tool all of our cell blocks. That way it'll be faster. I'm not going to give these guys anything inside of this. They're not getting TVs. They're not getting a workout bench or anything like that. Forget that noise. These are just basic confinement cells, like I said. So throw a toilet there. Maybe in the future, when we expand, we have a lot more money coming in. We can give these guys something fancier, something better. But for right now, we don't really have a lot of money coming in. You know, we're going to build a very big workshop, just so you guys are aware. Hopefully that'll be one of our main sources of money. I'd like to get something that's going to get us like $8,000 a night. So that's going to require a shit ton of license plate makers. So hopefully we can get more than this crappy 800 and 1500 grants for the number of prisoners we have, because that sucks. That sucks so hard. And it's not going to do me any favors at all. Let's get these offices all set up. I still don't think I've realized that they're a mistake. Okay, there we go. Now I realize. They're supposed to be 4x4, and I made them 3x3. Big oversight. Big freaking oversight. Because now, how do I do this? How do I fit this in and still keep room for the capacitors? And a hallway so they can, you know, so it'd be realistic. They could actually access their offices. All right, we got to demolish these as it is right now. Nothing we can do about that. That was a big stupid mistake on my part. I can't believe I didn't notice that when I was building it. I mean, I've built these a few times. I should have known that it needed to be 4x4. Just slipped my mind, I guess. But that's going to be costly. That's going to be a costly mistake because I got to figure out. At this point, I'm trying to figure out how the hell I can build it still with this power plant where it is, because the hallway. I was hoping for just a 1x1 or one wide hallway on this side of the building, but I can't have a one wide hallway and make these 4x4. So how the hell do we solve that problem? Because we still want to keep our prison looking at least aesthetically decent looking, right? I mean, I don't want to have some ugly shit looking garbage prison. I want to have a good looking prison, you know? Something that's symmetrical. I love symmetry, if you haven't figured it out by my designs of the cell blocks. Symmetry is very important to me. I like to have things that look decent and they make sense. But I don't know. We'll figure it all out at the end. Let's get these prison doors opened up for these guys so they don't have to wait for a guard to show up, because God knows the guards are so useless. But we'll install power here so that all the rest of these cells get some electricity. Seem a little stretched. Let's put all these doors to open for right now. That way we can get all this shit installed. I mean, we got 5 minutes until another 8 prisoners show up. We don't even have cells for first 8. Still. Nor do we have a canteen. Nor do we have showers. So we're running behind. We should have probably paused that first 8 till we had the design up. But I like the pressure that it's causing to have to get, you know, the prison built while prisoners are showing up. You're being forced into that position. You're being forced into getting everything accomplished, and you're under the wire, you know? It makes it a little bit more challenging, because we can't just sit back and try and fine-tune everything. We've got to get it going. Now, this was stupid. I shouldn't have been assigning these cells until they were actually cells, because technically they're not going to meet the needs of those guys. Yeah, there's a toilet. Yeah, there's a bed, but they can't use the toilet. And the bed. Well, they can use the bed, I guess, if there's a bed in there. Anyway. So the workmen have started to dismantle the 2 office areas. That's good news. You know, perhaps we could, you know, maybe we should try for a theme. You guys give me a heads up. If there is a particular theme you want for this prison, such as, oh, crap, I don't even know. But maybe an oppressive... You know, an oppressive prison with more guards than prisoners, if we can financially sustain that and keep expanding. I don't know. Well, you guys give me some advice, though. Tell me something that you see that you don't like, or something that you think I'm doing wrong. Give me some heads up. You know, a lot of you guys have been playing this game a lot longer than I have. I just have a particular type of way that I like doing stuff, but I'm open for criticism, and I'm open for suggestions, absolutely. Because how else am I going to learn and get better at it, right? So, if you guys think that I should change a certain area of the prison to make it more functional, give me the heads up on that, because that would definitely help me out. But for right now, I'm trying to figure out exactly how the hell to make these into a 4x4 without a hallway for the doors. Because, I mean, how are the guys going to get in and out of their offices, right? There's no real way to make it happen. But, that was a stupid oversight on my part. So now we got a 4 there, but only a 3 on the outside. So that's not going to work. Or the inside, it's only 3x3. But hopefully we can get, we can get a full prison going here very soon. And we'll build another, we're going to have to build another cell block at this rate, because, I mean, we can only hold 22 prisoners, and they're showing up in batches of 8, which is 16. You know, that only leaves us, what, six extra cells, which adds the question of where are the other two guys going? They're going in the holding cell. So right now we have the capacity to hold, you know, we have the whole, we can hold 22 people in the cell plus another 8 in the holding cell. It's 30 prisoners in total. That only works out to be, what, 5 deliveries, basically, of prisoners. 5 deliveries of prisoners, and then we've run out of space. So that's not going to be very good. And that's with holding cell guys. I don't want guys in the holding cell. I'd rather them be all in their own individual cells. The holding cell is exactly what it is supposed to be. It's just there for a stopgap while you get the rest of the cells built. You know, I'm not going to give you, I'm going to give you guys a heads up. I'm not going to be wasting a lot of money on prettying up this place with a whole shitload of greenery and fancy tiles and all that stuff. There's no money for that at the beginning stages. Later on there is, but for right now, you know, the most I'm going to do is put down some tiles in the main hallway. The cells and offices are going to have to just deal with the lack of pretty floors and stuff for now. I will fix it later. Don't worry. Don't you worry. I will get around to it doing it later. But for right now, I can't. Because there's just no space. So here's my solution. I'm going to put the doors on the outside of the offices. Which, that'll do for now. You know, maybe eventually I'll figure out something. But it's not a huge pressing issue. I just wanted to make sure these guys actually had a way to get in and out of their offices, so they are actual offices. The doors on the outside will work just fine. They can always leave their offices and walk into the prison from the outside if they really had to, you know. What's stopping them? But anyway, not going to really pretty it up. Also, I mean, there's really no point, because you see that the holding cell? See how it's got the checker pattern? Well, when you assign rooms, that's what you get. You get this checker pattern over top of your fancy floor. So you can't really even tell it's a fancy looking floor anyways. So who cares at the end of the day? Because whether it's concrete floor or it's a tiled floor, it still looks crap with that checker pattern over top. You know, like the outer area of the cells here does work. And if you saw in one of my earlier videos before I stripped it away, because it was just too expensive to build in all the rest of them, I did have a metal floor in Belref Prison. In my first cell block, and I wasted like so much money building this metal floor with concrete tile inside the cell. And guess what? It was pointless. It doesn't affect the happiness of the prisoners or anything like that. And it was expensive out the ass, and I couldn't afford to keep adding it to all the other cells because there was just too much waste of money. So I'm not going to do that. So here I'm just going to plot out. You know, I'm going to try and get as many shower heads as I possibly can. It'd be great if I had a close to equal number of shower heads as I do prisoners in this cell block. That way you can always be assured that every prisoner is going to have his own shower head. So we've got 14 right there, and we're going to need at least 20. So let's see if I do it right there. 1, 2, 15, 16, 17, 18. 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. 24 is too much, so I'm not going to do it that way. But I'll space these out just like that. I can put one shower head or two shower heads on each block. And that should give me at least a decent enough number. So 1, 2, if I stagger them, 3, 4. So 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I'm going to end up with 20 shower heads, 22 prisoners per shower block. Cell block. That should give me more than enough ability to keep these guys happy. And you might laugh and you might say, what a waste of space, but trust me, it makes a difference. It makes a big difference. These guys don't have any lights. So we'll just fix that. Power all the offices. We got 4 offices right now, which is fine. Because what does that work out to? Warden, finance, maintenance.
That works. We work with this.
What are the other ones? Maintenance, chief of security. Those all require an office. I'm forgetting about two people here. The lawyer doesn't need an office because he doesn't do anything at the moment. Who's the other person? Who's the other bureaucracy person? All right, well, we need to get this canteen built because it is long overdue. And, I mean, we got another 2 minutes. Sorry, we have another 21 minutes before we get another helping of guys. We have 8 people who've just shown up that have no place to go. And we have no place to feed them. So this is gonna get ugly real quick if we don't get around to fixing this. Let's increase our deliveries area here because as you can see it's getting full up. Okay, we've got a good full size. Okay, everybody's got a good cell. Look. There we go. A bunch of guys are in the holding cells, but more or less everybody's doing okay right now. We really need to get the canteen and the kitchen built, though, because we're going to have an issue very soon of people not being fed. All right, so the workmen are starting to build that, and this guy's starting to build the other two cells. All right, healthcare. I forgot about the nurses. And mental health, that's right. So mental health needs an office as well. We got to get our security guy in place here. Deployment and contraband are a big issue that we need to address. Maintenance, obviously we need a janitor at some point because he's got to start getting this place clean or else the foundation's going to get really dirty. And I don't know if the prisoners react too well to that or not. I haven't really seen it. I've always had a janitor cleaning up. It doesn't look very nice, to be sure. But I don't know if it directly, at this stage of the alpha, affects their happiness. It makes them riot if they're stuck in dirty conditions. I don't really know. Don't know. But anyway, let's see what we got going on here. Okay, so he's got that cell up and running. We're just going to get all the shower heads connected. Keep it the minimum amount of piping that we have to, because pipes are expensive. I mean, $6 a pipe, that doesn't sound like a shit ton of money, but it adds up. So let's get all of our shower heads installed. That way we can get hygiene taken care of. Hygiene is a big issue. The guys don't like being smelly and gross. The faster you can get hygiene installed, the better for everybody. We're going to get another 2 guards here. 1, 2. And this is why we need deployment, because they're just walking out of here and they're going back to the areas that I don't want them in, which is a pain in the ass. Okay, so let's get the door installed on that. We got $33,000 left. 16 prisoners, 11 prison cells at the moment. We can work around this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 20 shower heads. That'll be more than enough for each cell block. And we'll see. Again, I've never done it quite like this. I've never done a cell block quite like this. You've seen my other prison. That's kind of the way I stayed with it. We'll see how the prisoners like this setup. I think it's going to work out pretty well, though. Some of you might question the size of my canteen, like at this early stage of the game. Really don't need to make canteen this big. No, you don't. But trust me, eventually when you have 60 prisoners sitting in this canteen, thank God it's finally built, or 100 prisoners in your prison, the bigger your canteen, the better. Trust me, it makes a freaking huge difference. Because right now we can have, what, 60, 66 prisoners with our current layout. But when we expand downward, which will be the next place I expand to, it's going to, or perhaps I'll be expanding off to the right, I don't know. But anyway, when we expand and we add another bunch of these cell blocks, it's going to make a difference. So we'll just add those capacitors right there for the cooking equipment that's going to be coming up real soon. We just got to worry about power's going to work out into that cell just fine once it is built. What's he doing? Oh, he's building the wall. So I think we're going to call it right here for this part here. This will be the end of part two. And then, guys, we're going to get around to part three very shortly. All right, hope you're enjoying this. Leave me comments, likes, and subscribe if you're really enjoying this. And I'll let me know that you guys want more of it. But anyways, make every day an even better day. I'll see you guys in part three.